We've all walked to the wall and changed the temperature on a thermostat, whether in a house, apartment, or office. Thermostats come in all shapes and sizes and allow us to control our heating and cooling by reading the temperature in a room and responding to the user's set points. In this video, we're going to talk about the differences between a single set point and dual set point thermostat. Let's start with the simpler single set point thermostat. A single set point allows the occupant to tell a building automation system the desired temperature of a space. This is a common way that residential thermostats work. Pick a set point, and the system will automatically heat or cool to keep the space at temperature. The thermostat will also have what is known as deadband and hysteresis. Deadband is the amount the room temperature can move away from the desired set point before turning your heating or cooling system on. For example, if we set a thermostat to 74 degrees in the winter and it has been configured for a deadband of 4 degrees, heating will not be triggered until the room reaches 70 degrees. This will ensure that the system is not constantly turning on or switching between heating and cooling with every minute deviation from the set point. Next, hysteresis is a way to lag the response of your HVAC system for the purposes of saving energy and equipment wear and tear. Again, for our example, we set the set point to 74 in the winter. With a hysteresis, the system may warm the space to 76 degrees, shut off, then allow the space to cool down to say 72 degrees before heating the space again. Typically on newer thermostats, the hysteresis and deadbands are pre-programmed into the controls, so there's no need for occupants to worry about these features. And overall, the minimalism of a single set point makes for simple user interaction, and it's very intuitive to use. Now, let's look at a dual set point thermostat. As the name would suggest, a dual set point thermostat has two distinct set points, one for heating and one for cooling. This allows for more control of the deadband, as the user now selects the temperatures required for the HVAC system to make a changeover from heating to cooling or vice versa. As you can see, this allows for tighter control of the system, leading to energy savings and money in the facility's owner's pocket. During unoccupied times, setting these set points to a wider range could allow for additional energy savings. But at the end of the day, it comes down to simplicity and control and choosing which setup makes sense for the occupant. Here at KMC Controls, we offer a wide variety of thermostats that have options for single or dual set points. They also include CO2, motion, and humidity sensors built right in. To learn more about our specific thermostat offerings, check out the link in the description for this video. And for more Industry 101 content, check out our KMC 101s playlist. And to learn more about any of the solutions from the building geniuses at KMC, visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.